Eight Philippine cops tagged in the killing of a 17-year-old are officially dismissed from service. The Police Internal Affairs Service had recommended the dismissal of the eight Navota City policemen. They were charged with grave neglect of duty, grave irregularity in the performance of duty, and conduct unbecoming of a police officer. They have 10 days to file a motion for reconsideration. The dismissed policemen were implicated in the fatal August 2 shooting of Jemboy Baltazar, whom they allegedly mistook for a suspect. Baltazar's family filed a murder complaint against 19 cops, including the eight who were dismissed.
For the criminal proceedings under na yan sa Department of Justice, hindi na yan saklaw ng PNP. Pero yung ang make sure naman natin during the filing of cases is kumpleto yung mga statement ng mga witnesses. And of course, hindi natin walang cover up on the part of the PNP to make sure na justice will be served.
Two Filipino environmental activists who went missing in Bataan early this month, now under military custody. The National Security Council calls their alleged abduction an elaborate hoax and a scam. Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya asserts Jonila Castro and Jed Tamano voluntarily surrendered to military after leaving the communist movement. But rights groups slammed the government's claim. They also dared authorities to release the two activists who were now allegedly in an undisclosed safe house. The Armed Forces of the Philippines suspects China is harvesting corals in the Rozul Reef. The military also reported an increase in the presence of Chinese vessels in the West Philippine Sea. ABS-CBN correspondent Victoria Tula joins us live with the details. Vicky, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Rita. That's correct. In a forum in Quezon City this morning, Vice Admiral Alberto Carlos, commander of the AFP Western Command, said they observed coral harvesting in Rozul Reef, also known as Iroquois, sometime last July. Rozul is part of the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines in the West Philippine Sea. The AFP suspects Chinese military militia vessels to be behind this, since they were the ones stationed in the area before the AFP was able to drive them away. Carlos said no corals were left in the area, and to their untrained eye, it seemed as if the harvesting happened recently. The AFP officials said the activity is alarming because China is violating the sovereign rights of the Philippines. He emphasized that Filipinos should be the ones to enjoy the resources in the country's EEZ. It is also alarming because he says it might seem that the AFP is remiss in its duty in protecting the West Philippine Sea. Colonel Medel Aguilar, AFP spokesman, added that coral harvesting is a threat to the food security, not just of the Philippines, but of the world. Carlos said they are increasing their presence in the area and encouraging their allies to take action that will result in favorable condition on the ground. Another issue is the swarming activity in the contested waters. As of last night, 40 Chinese vessels were reported in Rozul Reef. In a statement yesterday, WESCOM said there were also 5 Chinese vessels in Escoda Shoal and 2 in Barangatan Bank as of early September. Carlos said they are addressing the problem by putting forces there. There are continuous efforts to file diplomatic protests against China, but as to filing another case in an international court, he says there's still no decision. Rika?
Hi, Vicky. When the AFP stated that they suspect coral harvesting happening, did they do an underwater check on this?
Yes, Rika. After they were able to drive the Chinese vessels away, they immediately sent their divers to the area, and the divers confirmed that the corals were destroyed, that there was nothing left there.
Mm-hmm. Rika? Well, one more. Were you able to ask AFP if what their thoughts are on the Senate's plan to come up with a new Philippine map?
Unfortunately, Rika, that wasn't discussed in the forum, and the discussion only centered on the recent activity in the West Philippine Sea. And one of another information that they gave out there is that they are studying also proposals for joint patrols from 8 different countries, including Singapore, U.S., and Australia.
All right, thank you so much. Victoria Tulad reporting live. The Philippine government vows to look for a possible extension of the jail term of Julie Biranara's killer. This after the family of a slain OFW expressed disappointment over the 15-year prison term slapped on the teenage son of Ranara's employer.
Naipaliwanag ko sa pamilya na sa kaso ng Salarin, minor de edad siya, kaya't merong pag-apply dito ng juvenile criminal law ng Kuwait. Aalamin natin sa ating abogado kung ano pa nga yung legal options.
We need to get in touch with our legal representative in Kuwait para mabigyan tayo ng proper guidance as to what we can do. Ang magagarantiyan naman natin, ang maganda rito, nakita nyo naman na hindi tayo nang iwan, hindi tayo bumitaw magmula nung pumutok itong bigat na trahedya na ito. Nandito pa rin ang pamahalaan para sila ay alalayan.
The Foreign Affairs Department has said challenging the ruling might take time.
Ang problema pag umapela. Pag umapela yan, kasama yan yung damages. So, baka tumagal pa. Pero ang punto, hindi na absuelto.
Renara's charred body was found in a Kuwaiti desert back in January. An autopsy report showed she was pregnant at the time of her death. Her murder sparked calls to halt the deployment of Filipino migrant workers to Kuwait and a review of the labor agreement between the two countries. At least four are injured after a fire drill at a school in Quezon City took an unexpected turn. Dennis Dato has more.
It was supposed to be just a fire drill, but it became a reality. Thick smoke enveloped Starland International School Friday morning in Cubao, Quezon City. Fire immediately spread throughout the entire campus. Students and teachers were quickly evacuated, with some of them fearing for their lives.
Umiyak po.
Umiyak rin po to.
Nagtakbuhan po kami kung saan-saan. Nagpanik kami talaga lahat.
The fire started before 9 a.m. Residents living near the school heaved a sigh of relief that they were not affected.
Sobrang pasasalamat ko talaga sa BFP dahil split second lang baka pati yung bahay namin nadamay. Medyo nakakatrauma lang ngayon.
The fire happened while the school was conducting the second part of the fire drill.
During that time po, nagpa-fire drill po kami. Ongoing kami sa fire drill. Tapos nung afternoon po, yan ang nag-start na po yung usok. So nag-start kami magpalabas ng mga bata.
But according to the Quezon City Bureau of Fire Protection, the school administration did not cooperate with the bureau for the fire drill.
Usually po, pag nagkaroon sila ng fire drill, dapat may coordination sa Bureau of Fire. Pero this time po, di sila nag-coordinate sa amin. Actually, hindi naman violation yun. Maganda nga, nag-exercise sila ng ganun. Sana, para hindi maulit tong ganitong insidente, sana nag-coordinate sila sa amin.
It cannot be determined yet if the fire drill is related to the fire incident. But it reportedly started in the storage area behind the kindergarten classroom where the school supplies and books were piled up. After an hour, the fire was declared fire out. The entire school, which made up light materials, was completely burned down.
Actually, old house to, ginawang school, ni-renovate, two-story siya na building.
There were 175 students and teachers at Starland International School when the fire happened. One teacher and three fire volunteers were slightly injured.
30 minutes, bumubuga po ako sa loob. Pagpaling ko po dito sa may kanan, hindi ko naman po napansin na live wire po pala yung nabugaan ko. Tumulay po yung kuryente. Agad ko naman po nabitawan yung nozzle.
Aside from the injured individuals, all students and staff of the school are safe. Dennis Dato, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Energy Department warns the string of oil price hikes could last until end of the year. This as pump prices are projected to increase for the 11th straight week. Diesel prices will see the biggest jump of as much as 2 pesos and 60 centavos per liter. Gasoline prices, meanwhile, might see an increase of at least 1 peso and 70 centavos per liter, while a liter of kerosene could go up by as much as 2 pesos and 30 centavos. With a continuous price hike, the DOE urges motorists to be wise in buying fuel.
Maging wise lang po tayo. Gamitin po natin yung power of choice, dito ba? Kasi pag makikita niyo po sa monitoring po ng Department of Energy, may mga gasolinahan na nagbibigay ng hanggang 4 pesos discount per liter. Nakapost sa amin yung mga prevailing retail prices. Naka-range po yan. Halimbawa po yung gasolina na ang octane ng 95, siguro magre-range po siya ng around nung nakaraan na wala pa pong adjustment, 61 hanggang 81.75. Ibig sabihin, meron pong ganong nagbibigay pa ng ganong kamura. So sana po yung mga mga mamamayan o mga motorista kung sakaling kaya pang umabot din yung kanilang gasolina, tatilihin po natin yun.
Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatchalian admits the confidential and intelligence funds government agencies are seeking have legal basis and safeguards. Still, Gatchalian says he wants to make sure these are being spent properly. The senator added he also wants to look into the estimated 13 billion peso contingency funds contained in the proposed 2024 budget.
Ang importante lang na dapat makita, tama ba yung pinaggagastosan nito?
Mm-hmm.
Ito mga pinaggagastosan nito ay ayon ba sa mandato, let's say, ng confidential intelligence funds? At pangalawa, kung kaya ilagay sa line item yung pinaggagastosan niyan, kung kayang ilagay na hindi naman makakaapekto sa national security o sa gagawin ng ahensya, ilagay na lang as line item. At yun ang dapat busisiin at yun ang ako personally yun ang gusto kong makita.
The spending bill will be up for deliberations at the House plenary next week. The 5.7 trillion peso proposed budget hurdled the House committee level with 10 billion peso in confidential and intelligence funds intact.